Hi, I'm Kate, and in this video, you'll learn what to do when you encounter the "Sorry, this file type is not permitted for security reasons" message in WordPress. Before we do anything, make sure that you have a backup of your site. Also, some of these fixes involve copying code from the knowledge base article that corresponds to this video and pasting to your website's file with the help of cPanel or FTP. If you don't know how to use these methods, you can learn with the knowledge base article that we've linked in the description. We'll go over what causes this error message and easy solutions to fix it. You can skip to the part you prefer with the timestamps in the description. Like the error says, some files are not allowed for security reasons. Hackers could use this to take down your website, or well-intended users could break the website by accident. Let's start with the file types allowed by default in WordPress that are listed on the screen. All of these types follow the MIME Internet Standard, which stands for Multipurpose Internet Mail Extension. Even though the term has the word mail, meaning electronic mail, it's also used for web pages. MIME files have types, which work as categories, and subtypes, which are the actual file types. The solutions we'll cover allow all users to upload files in the formats you determine. This leads to security concerns, so you should follow some measures to keep your site secure while still allowing specific upload types. Limit the types of files uploaded to only those truly necessary. Limit the size of the files that can be uploaded. Use a WordPress security plugin to keep an eye on your site for flaws. Scan your WordPress site for possibly malicious code regularly. Restrict non-registered users to only uploading the file types that they require. One way to do this is a file upload form. The first recommendation we have is that you check and correct the file type extension spelling. While editing or saving a file in your computer, you may accidentally erase or mistype a file name extension. So you need to check and correct the file type extension spelling and then upload the file. Since beginners may have difficulty adding code to their functions.php or wp-config.php files, the first solution we'll cover is a WordPress plugin. Install and activate the File Uploads Type plugin from your WordPress dashboard. The plugin already offers a list of MIME types, so you can start by searching for the type you want on the search bar above the table. If the file type you want isn't in the table, you can add it at the bottom of the page. You'll need to fill out three fields: a description, the MIME type, which includes the type and subtype that we mentioned earlier, and the file extension. The first of two solutions involving code that we'll cover is adding a one-liner code to your wp-config.php file. This is a simple approach. However, it's not ideal for every website, as it removes all file type restrictions. In case multiple users upload files to your WordPress site, you can edit the functions.php file and upload only certain file types. You can copy the code from the knowledge base article that corresponds to this video. Next, access your site via FTP or your web host cPanel, and search for wp-config in the public HTML folder. We recommend that you always make a backup of your wp-config.php file before modifying it, since even a minor file issue can make your site inaccessible. When you open the file, scroll down to the bottom and you'll notice the line, "That's all, stop editing, happy publishing." Paste the code before this line, save the changes, and re-upload the file. The second option that requires coding is adding the upload MIME filter to the theme's functions.php file. This method gives you control over the types that you'll allow to be uploaded. Keep in mind, however, that the change will be lost if you update the theme. Once you've backed up your site, you can access your functions.php file via the WordPress dashboard, FTP, or cPanel. Go to the knowledge base article that corresponds to this video. You can change the file types for the ones you want and add more types. Add the file extension between the brackets and the MIME type with subtype between apostrophes. You can easily add more file types if you're running a multi-site installation. On the left of WordPress's top bar, the network admin menu will show several options. Open the settings. Scroll down to Upload Settings, and you can add the extension for the file type in the input field next to Upload File Types. If you've tried all these methods but still get an error message, contact your WordPress hosting provider support team and explain your situation. It's likely that your provider imposed stronger file type restrictions than WordPress does by default. If this tutorial helped you, give it a like. If you have any questions, click on the link in the description to open a free support ticket. You can find more tutorials in our knowledge base at rankmath.com/KB.